video, we'll walk you through the quick process of setting up Neo4j Aura on Google Cloud. This journey will not only give you a nice, fully managed Neo4j instance, but it'll also nicely bundle your Neo4j costs into your standard Google Cloud bill, no additional billing or vendor management work necessary. Intrigued? Let's dive in. Now, let's start this adventure by running a search for Neo4j. A product page appears as the first result, a marketplace offering waiting to be unraveled. The next step, click subscribe, as you would on our channel, hint hint. A tiny but important detail, certain permissions are required for subscribing to marketplace products like this. These permissions must be activated to unlock Neo4j within a project. So, next up, let's teleport to the glamorous world of IAM roles and shed light on which pre-built roles hold the required permissions. The main options here are owner, editor, or billing account administrator, so assign one of those or a more pared-down custom role. After granting the required permissions on a separate screen, we'll teleport back to the subscription page and proceed. We see a variety of options for the instance, but note that these are here just to help us forecast costs. We'll actually provision instances later. After confirming, we're given two intriguing options for pressing forward. Manage Orders guides us to the GCP subscription management page, and the product page gets us closer to our actual Neo4j instance. Once actually in the Neo4j system, it's time to agree to the terms of service and create new instances. Make sure to capture the database connection password. You won't be able to retrieve it if it's lost. Finally, once your instance is alive and kicking, you have the power to manage it, pause it, or even delete it, all depending on how you want to handle your dependent workloads and costs. The Connect option serves as a bridge linking certain applications and integrations to our Neo4j instance. Pause the instance to reduce your costs to about 20% of the running costs, but while retaining data for when you fire the instance back up. Did we mention how you can cancel the subscription? Just hop over to Manage Orders and extinguish the order there. If you aren't running any instances, you won't have any associated costs, but for cleanliness, you should still cancel the subscription. We hope that this video has proved helpful and want to thank you for watching. Please enjoy responsibly.